In this video, I'm gonna rank the best and worst legendary pair cards, and I'm gonna tell you which one you should use in your build. To be much more easier, I break down this video in four parts. First, we're gonna talk about damage legendary pair cards. After, we're gonna talk about survivability legendary pair cards. After, we're gonna talk about convenience legendary pair cards. And at the end, we're gonna talk about the worst legendary pair cards that you should never use. Let's see how can you found your legendary perk cards. Just gonna open your Pip-Boy, open to your build. You can see your build and right up there you have legendary perk cards. You can have a maximum of 6 slots for legendary perk cards and you're gonna need to be over level 300 to earn it all. So if you're a new player, you're not gonna get them all. You're gonna need to be over level 300 and in time you're gonna earn them all the spaces. Now there is multiple legendary perk cards. As you can see, the thing about these legendary perk cards is that you need to level them up. Now in order to level up a legendary perk card, you need perk points. As you can see, they're always giving us the first level for free and the second one is gonna cost you 50 perk points, and after 100 and after 150, so it's gonna take you 300 perk points to level up a legendary perk card to maximum. Now to get perk points, it's really easy. What you need to do is just to scrap perk cards. For example, as you can see, I have over there the option to scrap it, and it's saying here that I can scrap it and I get 6 perk coins for this perk card. So you're gonna need to scrap a bunch of perk cards in order to get a bunch of perk coins to level up your legendary perks. It's gonna take you a long time to level them all up, but it's worth it. So first let's talk about damage legendary perk cards, and the first one is gonna be follow through. This perk card at max it's saying range sneak damage increase damage to target by 40% for 10 seconds. Which means if you have this perk card on maximum, you can do 40% more damage on your target for 10 seconds. This is a massive amount of damage. Keep in mind this damage is still multiplicative, not additive. So this perk card is quite strong. I do recommend to use this perk card with any type of range sneak attack build, from stealth commando to stealth shotgun to stealth pistols, whatever are you using. If it's working with stealth and it's a range weapon, this perk card is gonna be extremely strong. Far-flung firework. This legendary perk card says enemies killed with a range weapon have a 20% chance to explode. So this legendary perk card is doing an area effect damage, which can be quite useful in events like Scorched or Colossal Problem or any type of situation when you're facing multiple enemies at the same time. You just kill one enemy, that enemy is gonna explode and is gonna do damage on the other enemies over there. So can be quite strong. I do recommend you to use this perk card well with pretty much any type of build that it's using range weapons. Taking one for the team. This legendary perk card says enemies take 40% more damage when they attack you if you are in a team. So if you are in a team and something is attacking you, you do more damage on that enemy. I do recommend you to use this perk card with any type of build, either range or melee build. It's gonna make your character to be much more stronger. I personally use this one obviously on my melee build and also on my heavy gunner build. Hack and slash, 50% chance for melee VATS attack to do area damage. This is the strongest legendary perk card for a melee build. I personally use this one on my melee build, and when you use VATS, this perk card have a really high chance to proc, and the area effect damage that is doing, it's quite strong. So if you are going for a melee character, definitely put this perk card in your build. Another melee perk, it's Explosive Palm. Will unarmed, 20% chance to trigger an explosion on attacking hits. So, this legendary perk card is quite interesting. It's saying when unarmed, you can use unarmed weapons such as the Moon Miner Gauntlet, the Power Fist, Bare Arm, Meat Hook, and other weapons like that. Those are unarmed weapons. So, if you're using those weapons in your melee build in a combination with Explosive Palm, you can do explosive damage when you're punching your target. And who doesn't want to punch something and that thing to explode? It's definitely a reference to One Punch Man. Collateral damage. Enemies killed with a melee weapon have a 20% chance to explode. So this is basically like Fire from Firework. That one was giving you a 20% chance for the enemy to explode. If you're killed with a ranged weapon, this one is giving you the chance to explode with a melee weapon. Again, can be quite strong, and I do use this one on my melee build also. Now let's talk about survivability legendary perk cards, and the first one is Electric Absorption. This one is saying 20% chance enemy energy attack recharge your power armor fusion core. So it's not just recharging your power armor fusion core, it's also healing you. If you're a power armor user, you need to use this perk card. It's only working in power armor. So, if any type of enemy that is using energy weapons is going to attack you, can recharge your fusion core and also can heal you. It's kind of a hidden ability of this legendary perk card. Not just recharging your fusion core, it's basically recharging your health bar also. Funky dudes, this is a must-have for any type of blooded player. So if you're a low health player, you need to use funky dudes. This one is just simply giving you poison resistance. The worst thing for a blooded player, it's obviously poison damage that can kill you extremely fast. But with this legendary perk card, you don't need to worry about that anymore. I do use this perk card on pretty much all my blooded characters, so it's really a must-have. Power Armor Reboot. 40% chance to auto revive with full health if you're downed in Power Armor. It's obviously a really strong legendary perk for any type of blooded heavy gunner build because this perk card can just save you. If you're downed, this is giving you a 40% chance to auto revive you. Also, this perk card does work in PvP, so can be quite useful. This perk card just can instantly fully heal you with no problem. Sizzling Style. This one is giving you fire resistance. So it's exactly like Funky Dudes, just that one is giving you poison resistance. Now, I do recommend you to use this one, but I think Funky Dudes is much more better because poison damage is much more common than fire damage. But obviously, both of them, they can be quite useful, especially for low health players. Now let's talk about convenience legendary perk cards. And the first one is Ammo Factory. This one on max is saying produce 150% more rounds when crafting ammunition. So this one basically is just giving you more ammo for your resources. You spend the same amount of resources, but you get 150% more rounds, which can be quite useful, especially for a heavy gunner or a commando build. I do recommend you to have this perk card at least on 3 or even on max if you can. And other convenience legendary perk cards are the legendary stats, such as intelligence, endurance, luck, agility, strength. You can choose which one you think would be much more useful for your build. I think the most useful ones are intelligence, strength, endurance, and luck. For example, in intelligence, if you get this one on max, you can get more intelligence when you're gonna farm XP. You can make your character to be a high intelligence build. If you want to go for a melee character, this one is gonna be quite useful for your legendary strength to have more strength, which equal more damage and more carry weight. You can go with legendary endurance if you want a super tanky character, or if you want to go for a stealth build to get that 33 luck to do a critical every second shot, you're gonna need legendary luck. So it really depends on which type of build are you running, and you should pick the one that really gonna help you in the future. Now let's talk about the worst legendary per cards, and the first one is Blood Sacrifice. When you die, teammates gain plus 40 damage resistance and heal 70 HP over 14 seconds. Again, to invest 300 perk points in this perk card just to get that 40 damage resistance and some healing out of it is just not worth it. Just not worth it at all. I don't consider this perk card to be useful. It just really doesn't matter. Just really doesn't matter. That 40 damage resistance and some healing, it's not gonna help you. You can use other camps that can boost your HP and damage resistance for a period of time for free, basically, and not to spend perk points for this legendary perk card. Brawling Chemist. Generate 2 combat enhancing camps every 40 minutes up to max 5. So this one is definitely for melee players, can give you a combat enhancing camp, which is just gonna be a camp that probably is gonna boost your strength, endurance and other stats for a short period of time. Now the problem with this perk card is that there is so many camps in this game, so many camps in this game that I can just farm and they can boost my stats for a short period of time. So I don't really see the use out of this perk card because it just doesn't worth to invest 300 perk points in it just to get some extra camps when you can farm camps in this game very easily and boost your stats for free. Detonation Contagious. Now this one it's actually a damage perk, but it's a bad one. Enemies killed with a throw explosive have a 50% chance to explode. So what does that mean? If you can kill something with a grenade or any throwable explosive, you get a 50% chance that is gonna explode after. So I don't know. I didn't see a lot of situations where you could kill a bunch of enemies with a grenade and after they're gonna explode. It just really doesn't worth the 300 perk points spent in this. And my question is, how often do you use grenades? Master Infiltrator. Right, so this one is saying auto unlock skill tree terminals and locks. So this one can be quite useful, I guess, but again, just doesn't worth to invest 300 perk points in it just to auto unlock some stuff. It just doesn't worth it. Saves in this game, they're not gonna give you a bunch of good stuff like in other Fallout games, and yeah, it's just really a waste of perk points if you're using this perk card. And I don't see a lot of use out of it. I know you're gonna say can be quite useful in the silo. We all know how we're doing nukes in this game. We all know how we're getting so fast to launch a nuke, right? So just don't use it. Power Sprinter. Now I did use this perk card in the past and I consider it to be quite useful, but after I got 15 endurance, this perk card it just doesn't worth it anymore. It's saying willing power armor sprinting consume 50% less AP. So can be useful, but I don't consider it to be as useful. I don't know. It's just not good enough. I tried it, I used it for a while, and honestly didn't feel like it was worth all the perk points that I put in this perk card. So learn from my mistake and don't use Power Sprinter. Retribution. I remember when they announced these legendary perk cards and everybody was hyped about it because it sounds to be pretty strong, and it was pretty strong, but it's not anymore. It's saying blocking, a melee attack restore 4 HP and 4 AP for 15 seconds. Now, the problem with this perk card is that it just doesn't worth it again. For what, 4 HP and 4 AP for 15 seconds? I remember that when they announced it, this thing was stackable. So you could stack that 4 HP and AP. It was quite strong. But now you can't stack it, and it just doesn't worth it. And if you're a melee player, how many times did you block? Because I have a melee character, and I can't really remember many times when I really, you know, stayed and block an enemy. I just punch everything down and kill it, and that's all. Survivor Shortcut. This legendary perk card should not exist anymore. They should delete it and create another one instead of this one. It's saying generate 2 survival 8 cam every 20 minutes up to max of 10. So basically, what's that survival cam? This one is gonna cure all your diseases, gonna fill up your hunger and thirst meter. Now, if your hunger and thirst meter are down to 0, you're not getting any negative effect. If they are on max, you're getting some positive effects. In the past, when this perk card came out, if you would have low water and low food, you would get negative effects on your character. That doesn't happen anymore. So this perk card, it's extremely useless now. Water adds. Now this one, personally, I don't consider it to be useful, but I did see some use out of this one. So basically, this one is giving you plus 300 rad resistance, restore 6 rads per second. So what that mean is basically you get more rad resistance and you can restore more rads. But I did see some pretty interesting combination with this legendary perk card and Ghoulish. The Ghoulish perk card, it's healing you if you're getting radiation damage, and this one is curing your radiation damage. So if you have both of them, you can make a pretty interesting combination of healing against enemies that are doing radiation damage on you. But again, it just doesn't really worth it. What kind of situation would that be useful? On a melee character, probably. Because I don't see use of it on a stat build or on a heavy gunner build. It's much more for melee players, but I don't think personally that it's worth the 300 perk points. And rad resistance, you can just take a rad axe or you can take a diluted radovane and you're good to go. So again, it just doesn't worth it. There is camps that can do the same thing basically for free. Legendary Charisma is definitely the worst one. If you're trying to boost your charisma with this perk card, it just doesn't work. I mean, it does work. You can boost your charisma by 5 points on max, but if you're trying after to share a perk card in your team, it just doesn't letting you, because technically you don't have that charisma. It's really strange with this one, so I definitely don't recommend you to use the legendary charisma. Alright, so that should do it. Those are all the best and worst legendary perk cards in Fallout 76. Hopefully this video is gonna help you to make a better decision when you're gonna pick your legendary perk cards for your build. If you like this kind of video, don't forget to press the like button, subscribe. Also, if you feel like you want to support the channel, you can do it on Patreon. You can find the link in the description for that. If you're a Patreon member, you do get a private chat with me and the other Patreons on my Discord, and you get early access to all of my videos. And also, your name is gonna be in my videos. And again, thank you very much for watching, guys. And obviously, see you guys in the next one.